Hi, and welcome to another filmmaking tutorial. My name is Tom Antos, and today I'm going to show you guys a simple but very useful little lighting trick that you can use in your next maybe film or music video. The example that I'm actually going to be showing you is from a music video that I shot recently. And basically, we start off with something like this. It's basically inside a movie theater. That's the actual lighting that was in the theater. And we end with this. So, as you can see, this little scene is about a couple that goes out to a movie theater for the first date. And I basically have to simulate, you know, the light that would come off of a screen, a movie screen, while watching a movie. Now, in real life, while you're watching a film inside a theater, it's so dark that you would not even be able to really get an exposure, even with digital SLRs. Like, maybe if you bumped up the ISO to, you know, all the way to, I don't know, 6400, you'd get some kind of an exposure, but it would be still fairly dark and obviously very grainy and just flat looking. Now, here's how the theater looks inside with its lights on. It's still, as you can see, fairly dark. It's this image is underexposed by about 1 or 2 f-stops, and it's also grainy because I had to put the ISO up to 1600, I believe, and it's just not interesting looking. It's kind of flat. So what I basically decided to do is to simulate the kind of the light bouncing off of the movie screen by simply putting a big 1000 watt redhead. The tungsten light, but you can use pretty much even a work light or any kind of a light will do. Doesn't have to be redhead. Basically, I put that light right in front of the actors, kind of pointing, you know, at their faces. The light it's basically behind and above the camera, and just points directly at the actors. And as you can see, right away, just kind of gives you that effect of the light kind of coming off the screen. But of course, you know, what the image is still missing is it's sort of flat. It gets sort of darker there, you know, in the distance, and there's nothing else really in this scene. So to make the scene kind of a little bit more three-dimensional, I added a little rim light, which is, you can see here on the left side there behind the actors. It's just basically slightly behind the actors and just to the left side of the screen, so it's just out of frame. And that light is again a 1000 watt redhead. Again, you could use any work light, you know, hardware light, whatever you have. And now to make that light kind of just, you know, look a little bit different than the light coming from the screen, I gelled it blue. So just by putting a little blue gel on it, I right away changed the color of it, and as you can see, it just kind of, you know, makes the scene a little bit more three-dimensional. You can see that the rim light kind of, you know, makes the actors and those seats there kind of stand out. And that's pretty much it for the lights. Now, the only thing, as you'll see here, that the scene is missing is basically it's not moving. Basically, the light doesn't change. And obviously, if you're in a movie theater, the you know, images on the screen would change, and therefore the intensity and the color of the light would change along with it. So, in order to simulate that, I basically created this very simple lighting trick. You can see me here kind of testing it out. Basically, all it is, it's a simple like a light stand that I've actually from a hardware light that I had lying around. You can see it has these kind of three legs under, and I took some tape and took a red and then a blue and a gel, lighting gel, and I basically taped them to the light stand, to those legs there, and then I left basically one side without any gel on it. And then I simply go and put that in front of the light, a 1000 watt light that kind of shines directly at the actors' faces, and I just basically rotate it, as you can see up here. And what that does is basically it creates this constant kind of, you know, flickering effect on the light. It kind of makes the light kind of slightly change in intensity, the colors change every so on from warmer to cooler to just kind of neutral. And just right away, that kind of makes the whole scene kind of come alive, as you can see up here. And then basically after that, the final thing we'll do is a slight color correction. This scene doesn't really need a lot since it's for a funny music video, so we want it to look, you know, more or less natural. But just sort of, you know, I adjust the contrast again, kind of I increase the contrast, And then I adjust the saturation. I kind of put the saturation a bit down so the colors don't blow out. And that's basically it. Now the only thing is that in this scene, after the couple, you know, basically watches the movie, basically what happens in the scene is that the movie ends, and so then the theater lights have to kind of, you know, come on. And since the actual lights in the theater, like I said earlier on, were too dim, I had to simulate that. So all I did is I put two softboxes. There were fluorescent lights because I just wanted the light to kind of feel drastically different from the movie theater lighting. And I placed two of those softboxes sort of facing the actors from the, you know, from the front, but both on each side, on the left and the right side, kind of at a 45 degree angle. And that's pretty much it. Hope you guys liked it. Stay tuned for more tutorials. And before I go, I'm gonna let you guys see a bit more of this hilarious new music video. It should be premiering soon on the Nocturnal Emissions website, or you can check out their YouTube channel as well. I'm gonna post the links up in the video. And in the meantime, while you're waiting for the music video to premiere, go check out their other hilarious videos, which they have up on their YouTube channel. All right, enjoy it, and see you guys next time. First date, don't want to jinx it, but so far it's going really great. Get to the movie, romantic comedy. My stomach rumbles and my dinner starts to haunt me. There is no hiding this, this fart is coming out. The best thing I can do is see if I can squeak it out. Wait for the loud part, lift up my leg and start. Ease it out and hope that this is just a silent dart.